I'm Michelle Kuzma from Columbus, Ohio, and today I'm going to prepare for you my take on a baraka recipe. A baraka is a traditional Jewish food. My grandmother used to make it with a very light and tasty pastry filled with cheese or potatoes and cheese. And today I'm going to prepare for you my twist on that traditional recipe, and I call it purple potato barakas. So you might ask, what is a purple potato? Well, a purple potato actually is a purple potato. I'm not sure how well you can tell in this video what color they are, but they're usually small, almost the size of new potatoes, and they have kind of a purplish hue to them. And they've been known to have better health benefits. So I thought, well, why not try them in barakas? I have already ahead of time boiled the potatoes and taken off their skins and mashed them. And here they are in a bowl. And you can kind of see how nice and light purple, almost like a lavender color. They taste very, very similar to a red new potato, and they're delicious. So right now I have in this bowl a half a cup of mashed purple potatoes. Also ahead of time, I prepared a quarter cup of sauteed onions. I took a tablespoon of butter. This is going to be a dairy dish. And I've got a quarter cup of onions that have been sauteed in a tablespoon of butter. I'm going to add that to my potatoes. And to give them a little bit more of a creamy texture, instead of adding like a sour cream or another type of cheese, I updated it and have given, I've got a tablespoon of Greek yogurt, just plain Greek yogurt. So I'm going to add a tablespoon of plain Greek yogurt to the mixture. And then for the cheesy part, I'm going to add a cheese that I have just fallen in love with. It's called Cotija cheese, and Cotija is a Mexican cheese. It's crumbly like a feta, but tastes more like a Parmesan. I believe that they like to call it a Mexican Parmesan, but when I pour it into the bowl, you'll be able to see I've already crumbled it. I've got a quarter cup of crumbled Cotija here, and this is the cheese I'm going to use for my mixture. So you can see that it's already been crumbled. And I'm just gonna add that in. It's kind of a salty cheese too, so it adds a lot of flavor to the inside of the dish. So then I'm just gonna take this and mix it all together, mix it really well so that all the ingredients get well mixed together. You'll see that it still retains its really pretty purple hue. You can also see that I've already taken, to shorten this recipe and make it quick and kosher, I have taken already prepared frozen puff pastry, and I've thawed it out and used a rolling pin to roll it into a square that was 12 by 12. And then I cut it into individual squares, and that's going to be the pastry for my barakas. Okay. So now that I've got that mixture all nicely mixed up, you can probably see that in the bowl, I'm gonna take my tablespoon again, and take about a tablespoon of the mixture onto one of the squares of the puff pastry. And I just find it's easier to use my hands. And you kind of push it into, make a triangle out of it, into the corner of one of the corners of the puff pastry dough. Then you take the other corner, you bring it up over, press the edges down, but you've got a nice triangle of puff pastry. Now to keep that sealed in the oven, because we are going to bake these, I've already preheated my oven to 350 degrees. In order to keep the edges together, I'm also going to use the tines of my fork and crimp it down along all the edges here. Keep it together so that it looks like this. Okay. Then I'm going to put it on a parchment lined cooking pan, cookie sheet, and then I will, I should finish off the one so I can show you, I can demonstrate the whole thing. I take, I have one beaten egg here, and I'm going to take it with a pastry brush and just brush the top of it. Give it a nice golden color when it's baking, but it also helps because we're also going to add some sesame seeds to the top. So you take just some regular sesame seeds, sprinkle them on top. They get baked in the oven at 350 degrees for 30 to 35 minutes or until they're nice and brown. And I will be back in a little while to show you exactly what I get. Well, here I am back with my baked baracas. You can see they just came out of the oven, so they're really hot, so I needed to use my oven mitts here, but I want you to get a nice look at them. You can see that some of them may have opened just a teeny bit, but that's okay. You know, it's just extra filling to sample later. And I just figured I would plate up a few for you here so you can get an idea of what they look like. Thought we'd cut into one to see how they look. Alright, so let's take a look and see. You can hear the pastry is nice and crispy, which is exactly what we want. And oh, look at that beautiful purple potato. You can see it's steaming right now. Looks delicious. Mm. The cheese and the onions, the potato, delicious. I highly recommend you try these purple potato baracas. Thanks for watching.